Hey, this is Terry. Dumbbell 101, here we go. We're gonna do basic movements, get you through the first few weeks, then we'll go to something a little more advanced after that. These are 8-pound dumbbells. You can use 5 or 10s, start low. The idea is to really start on warming up the joints, the tendons, and get things moving. I prefer to get a little blood pumping in the muscles before you stretch them. Never stretch a cold muscle, okay? So let's just take these down. So first we're gonna get our shoulders going. A little rotator cuff action.
Hey mister, what's your name?
My name is Mr. Christina.
Introducing Terry Godwin.
This is why they call me Mr. Christina. So let's get the shoulder joints good and warm. They take the most punishment, if you will, during a sequence. Loosen up the knee joints.
Go.
This is all has a purpose. Let's open up the chest. Gently, nothing crazy. Now, if you're using a 3.5, 5-pound weight, this will be nice. The best movement to start with, I believe, is a shoulder press. So let's start here. Now, you can hold them palms facing forward. If it's more comfortable, you can have them palms facing your ears. All you're doing is going from about 90 degrees, see my elbows, 90 degrees, press up. No need to lock out. No need to come up here. Just stay right there. Look up a little bit. Knees are soft. That's the shoulder press. On the side. Palms forward, palms to the side, whatever is more comfortable for your rotator cuff. Pressing something over our head, number one. Now, I want to get into a push-up position. Since it's been a while, let's do it like this on our knees. Your arms here, I would just go all the way to the ground. Get your hands in a comfortable spot and just push up. Pause, push up. Pause, push up. That's the push up. Then when you get ready to do more, the body is in plank. The elbows kind of come down towards your waist. Press back up. If you like, you can start from the ground with your hands further apart, press up, all the way to the ground, press up, all the way to the ground, press up. If that's a little tough, finding a kitchen counter, leaning into it, and do these. That's actually a real good idea for warming up the chest muscles and warming up the shoulder tendons, okay? Also, you want to include in between those sets some type of stretching. I would say the garage door step or something, or you can just hold the wall, but stretch those calves because what we'll be doing will involve legs, and then come up. Hold it for a few seconds, stretch all the way down. Come up, hold for a few seconds, come all the way down. Stretch them. This gets the tendons and the muscles ready to be used. It's like stretching a rubber band, makes it more pliable. Now we did a shoulder press, we did a push-up. Now let's try something, that's for the front. Let's do something for the rear. With soft knees, come to an almost 90 degree. Let the weight hang out, look straight ahead. The back is straight. Pull. The shoulder blades together. Pull. Pull the shoulder blades together. Hold there. Hold there. Notice my feet are flat. I can feel my heels pushing in the ground. My knees are soft. My butt's out on purpose. It protects my lower back. Okay, so we've done the front and the back. Now our arms are warmed up. Let's curl. I believe that if you look at the muscle you're working when you're curling, you get a little more out of it. Here's something we don't want to do. We don't want to collapse. We don't want to collapse. It's constant tension. You can come in front of you more if you like. You can come out if you like. Just depends on how your arms move. Okay? Now, as though you're doing this and you're going here, it's a good idea to see if you can take these dumbbells down to your shin level and come back up. There. 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 And again, we're stretching tendons and stretching muscles so they're ready for heavier work. But with 5 or 10 pounds, that's ideal. Let's go back through it one more time. Press. Knees are soft. Row. Push up. Whichever variation works for you, use a pad. Pad's a good idea. Let's stretch those calf muscles. Hold 1, 2. Up 1, 2. Down 1, 2. Up 1, 2. Now, that's a pretty good upper body movement sequence with your dumbbells. Of course, everybody's favorite, the alternating dumbbell curls. Now, what are we going to do for legs? You can do this as one of the movements, or you can do this last. I like to hold this here like I would a wine glass goblet, and it is a goblet squat. Now, one way you want to work into this is hold on to something. Squat. 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 I'm not taking my legs past 90 degrees, as you can see. Then you can get better at it. Take your arms out in front of you. Squat. Squat. The butt goes that way, the arms are out here. Squat. When you get a little better, down, 1, 2, up. Down, 1, 2, up. Down, 1, 2, up. Now that's a few variations on a squat. That's good for firing up the legs. Then when you're getting better, you can take your dumbbell, and this really helps to balance you. Boom. It keep, and if you'll notice, using a dumbbell allows you to keep your back pretty straight vertically. Push through your heels. Chest is high. That will create soreness, so work on it. The beginning phase with just body weight as you get limber. Those are some basic movements to do with your dumbbell. That's where I would start. We call it a push-pull sequence, okay? So let's start with a push. While they're in your hand, almost 90 degrees, knees are soft, butt is out. Just row to the back. That's your pull. Okay, while we're here, let's go to another push. Now let's go to a pull. This is the one where the knees are soft again. You're just letting the weight stretch your hamstrings and come back up. Stretch your hamstrings, come back up. Slowly go down. One, two, three, one, two. One, two, three, one, two. Okay, now for your push, let's do a body weight squat. We're pushing with the legs. Here we go. Arms are out. Down, one, two. Down, one, two. Down, one, two. Down, one, two. That's your push. If you want to do the dumbbell, because this will make you sore, and the dumbbell's here. Down, one, two. Down, one, two. Okay? Another pull. The fun one, we do our bicep curl. We're pulling them up. Keeping the tension on. Knees are soft. The torso is still. Let the arms do the work. There's no swaying. Okay, now we get to breathe. Let's stretch our calf muscles down, one, two, up, one, two, down, one, two, three, up, one, two, three. By the way, you're on the balls of your feet, not your toes. You don't need to bounce. Just stretch it, hold it at the top. Stretch it. Hold it at the top. And that's a full body dumbbell circuit. Okay, I'm going to show you the whole circuit nonstop, 8 reps per movement, going through it twice. Okay, here we go. Thank you. That's it, with a few slight variations in each movement.
Good job, you've got this.